Hi guys, so you've seen one of my recent videos. I made this lovely modular sort of tile in the grimdark style. This is a 12-inch by 12-inch board. And my plan for these is to have them so I can play Necromunda, kill teams, boarding patrol. Any kind of game like that, really. And I'm still going to make about six of these initially. So this is the second one I made just recently. And this is the one I'm going to sort of show in this video how I've made it and, well, where you can get all the bits and pieces to make one of these yourself. I put little LEDs in, the little swampy bit there. So this is kind of like a container room. And as you can see, some of the barrels are, well, like toxic waste. So, as I said before, these are very modular. You can sort of join them together. I need to make the parts to join them. And I'll be doing that in probably the next video. Because I've got a cunning plan of making a way to join these, but you can't see the join. Keep tuned for the next one of these. So yeah, this is the container one that I'm going to go through in this video. I love how these look. Obviously, I do love the old grimdark style, nice and rusty, nice and aged. Lots of fun on there to play with. So they all start like this, good old MDF board with these sort of, just generic floor tiles, really. If you are looking for these, just type in, I think I've typed in fan tile in Thingiverse. But for the rest of the bits and pieces that are used on here, as you can see, I've already got loads printed out. Just to make things easier for myself, I'm kind of making bits box full of, well, bits, funny enough. So everything in this box and, well, what you'll see me use to make these modular tiles is all from the same place, which is Print Minis. So link in the description, guys, go check them out. As you can see, they do a whole variety of, well, it is kind of like Necromunda, apocalyptic, end of world sort of style stuff. From miniatures to tons of terrain, which is just awesome. I will say, these guys have sponsored the video, but obviously, as always, I say what I want, and yeah, I was lucky enough to be able to print out the bits that I wanted, which is just awesome. And I say, they do have a ton of, well, terrain pieces, which is great, and all their stuff is nice and modular, which makes things even better. So yeah, I downloaded the bits and pieces I wanted. Say, I have got a whole variety of stuff. Some of it I use in this, some of it I don't use in this video. But my main thought behind this sort of terrain piece was I wanted it to be like a container area, which is why I printed off loads of these containers. Using a good old Eligu 3D printer, nice and simple, usual thing, couple of clicks of a button, waits a few hours, and then, well, out pops a lovely sort of plate full of bits and pieces, really. And the other great thing I love about Print Minis, obviously other than the fact they do have a huge variety of bits and pieces, is you can get stuff pre-supported, which I just love. Yeah, occasionally I have a go at supporting my own stuff. Generally it does work because the software is getting better. But yeah, if you can get a model maker that pre-supports their stuff, then that makes things so much easier. As you'll see here, these things just, yeah, peel off. And the great thing is, obviously when they peel off, they don't leave much in the way of marks, which is another good sign that it's by a company that know what they're doing if they can make supports like this. So definitely go with a pre-supported file where possible. So as I said, I printed out loads of bits and pieces. I kind of have a rough idea of what I want to build and what I want to make. Sometimes things do change as they go along. So also my plan here is to have them so it'd be like, someone on the bottom and then someone on the top. But as you can see, they don't quite fit. So I had a little mess around with this center one and I took it into Tinkercad and I made it longer. Well, in fact, I made it longer, but then printed it in two parts. But as you can see, there's a bit of an error there. And this is where, well, I made my own supports. And yeah, some of them sort of failed. But the good thing is, it's still very usable, as this is sort of like a Necromunda, Grimdark style sort of piece. Yeah, bits that don't look perfect are, yeah, they fit in just perfectly. So yeah, doesn't matter about the little gaps there, here and there. But again, so that's where it does sort of make a big difference between someone who knows what they're doing with supports and then someone like me. So yeah, obviously the other thing I do think about when I'm putting these together is making sure that those are the connectors that connect one board to another board don't get sort of covered up. Otherwise that'll make it pretty difficult to sort of connect them. Again, guys, in the next video I'll be showing you the connectors and yeah, my little genius idea of making the connectors so you basically can't see them. My plan is to make initially six of these, which will be a board around the rough sort of size of Kill Team, as that is my sort of, well, that's my game that I love to play. although I do keep looking into Necromunda. It is a kind of a game and a style of play that would certainly interest me. So guys, if you play Necromunda, let me know down below what the main sort of bit about it is that you like. I keep looking at it and I keep thinking, I want to sort of go down that route. But my biggest problem is I get hooked very easily on something and then I just kind of go nuts for it. Which is kind of where I am with the kill teams. I think if I remember rightly, within the first 3 months of sort of getting the first rule book and starting to play this game, I had about 11 different kill teams even. I'd already built two separate sort of kill zone boards. Just because I love making things. And yeah, I'm a very visual person. So I do like things to look good. And I say with this game, I love having the aesthetics around it all to make it look like these little miniature figures are in the kind of zone or area they should be. So yeah, so again, this I love, say the print minis. They do a variety of options, so you can sort of buy separate miniatures and separate pieces, or you can become a patron, and then obviously you get access to their monthly sort of builds and makes. And I know this month they're doing quite a few sort of bits and pieces miniature wise, and you'll see some of the miniatures they're doing at the end of this video. So a lot of these pieces you'll see now are their previous sort of month's releases. But say you can buy everything separately or in sort of larger sort of packs. Which is really awesome. And say they do pretty much anything you can think of. And they even asked me if I could suggest a few items that they don't do that I would like to see. And yeah, so I've done that, and fingers crossed in the next sort of month or so, you might see some bits and pieces that I've specifically asked for. Which will be just pretty awesome. So in my last terrain video, a few of you guys mentioned having some sort of like toxic waste. And I really like the idea of doing that, because I want to have a go at messing around with some UV, with some resin. So yeah, that's why I've kind of got this crane jib sort of thingy here. The platform on it is sort of broken, and a few of these barrels have just, fallen off. And yeah, toxic waste, which is going to like burn through the mesh. So I printed out a few of these barrels, and I printed them out already pre-cut. And say now I just want to cut out an area. I want to use some resin, and I've also put some lights in the resin, as I want it to sort of have a glow effect. So you might have briefly seen that at the very beginning of the video. And yeah, it didn't come out too bad. I do need to work on my resin skills and my lighting skills, because say, it didn't come out too bad. I think it could have been better. A bit like my school report at school, I think. Yeah, tries hard, but could do better. Sort of sums up life, really, I guess. So, yeah, using a good old scalpel here. Although you will see later in the video, I do have a bit of an accident with a scalpel. Not on video, luckily. And I do sort of end up cutting my finger a little bit. So, yeah, the health and safety, guys. As always, don't do necessarily what I do. You guys take precautions, be safe, and yeah. It's a dangerous old hobby, isn't it? So yeah, this stuff's pretty easy to cut out, but obviously I glued it down using good old Gorilla Glue, which takes a while to dry, but when it does, it sets nice and strong. So the other thing, obviously Necromunda, I had a good old look at sort of obviously a lot of boards, and one of the main things I always see is there's always tons and tons of sort of tubing. I need to obviously have loads of tubing here. And this is where, I say this every time, 3D printers are just awesome. Obviously the fact that you can go online, grab what you want, and print it out. But more so, you can print out things to whatever size you want. So these bits I'm printing out, I think they initially were a whole lot bigger than this. But obviously resize them in the slicing software. And then, print things out at the exact size you need. Which is just awesome, because it does mean you can make things to fit. I know a lot of you will sort of say you haven't got 3D printers and you can't make this sort of stuff. And yeah, I am sorry, obviously, I am now leaning more towards 3D printed stuff. And I haven't really done any sort of scratch building for quite some time. I guess the main reason for this is kind of what I just said then, really. The fact that I can print things out exactly the size I want. And anything I kind of think of that I need, I probably can find online. And I think that's the way, obviously, things are changing now. That rather than scratch building something where it's sort of determined by what I've got to how it looks, this way I can build things exactly how they look in my head which is just awesome. So as you can see, it's coming along really, really nicely now. So loads of bits and pieces here. This is a bit of a mixture of quite a few of their sort of their packs that they do. But again, that's what I love about print minis, and the fact that everything they do sort of have is very interchangeable. And yeah, customizationable sort of thing. Yeah, you know what I mean? And yeah, it's just, yeah, tons and tons of awesome bits and pieces. So yeah, guys, don't forget, check out the link below. You won't be sorry at all. So having all the other bits and pieces sort of like pre-printed and in my, oh, my nice big bits box, certainly made putting this together nice and easy, because I had, say, tons and tons of stuff. And yeah, again, so this is pretty much how it looked in my head. I want a nice sort of container area with some barrels and a bit of a toxic waste situation going on. But I kind of thought this looked too, well, too nice, too neat. So I got one of these cheap little, well, it's not obviously a Dremel, but it's a nice little burring tool. And yeah, I'm going to use this because this is going to mess up this thing nicely. So basically, I'm just going to go around and put like, well, dents, scratches, and just make this thing look like it's sort of seen better days. It's been hit by a ton of things, maybe even bullets, who knows. But yeah, just going around the whole thing, just really messing it up. And I must admit, I think I had more fun with this than I probably should have. Yeah, I had to sort of control myself and not to mess things up too much, otherwise there wouldn't have been much much left that would have looked, well, half decent. As I mentioned earlier, say I'm going to make at least six of these to sort of make up a nice decent size that Mimimimate can play Kill Team on. So yeah, guys, again, let me know in the comments what sort of boards should I make. Yeah, so each board I am sort of trying to make them, well, have a sort of a purpose, a reason. But again, I like the idea of this being on a spaceship. So that's kind of where my head is with this whole board. It's going to be on a spaceship. I mean, it could be set on a planet. But yeah, guys, let me know if you've got any ideas of what sort of boards I should make. Just because, well, I like your input. And sometimes I do have brain farts and can't think of things. So yeah, guys, let me know. Yeah, what kind of boards should I make? I do the usual thing and look on sort of Google at Necromunda stuff. Just to try and get inspiration. But yeah, if you guys can let me know, that'd be great. So as you can see, this thing does obviously mess up the board, something rotten, but also messed up my desk, something rotten as well. So it took a while, but I finally had the cunning idea, well, while I'm doing this, why not have the old the vacuum cleaner out, yeah, sucking the mess up at the same time. Seems like common sense. I should have done this from the beginning, but hey-ho, sometimes common sense does sort of elude us. Especially when I'm filming, this is my excuse by the way guys, when I'm filming I do concentrate a lot on obviously camera angles, moving it around, making sure I'm actually sort of recording what I'm doing. Yeah, so next time I do this messy part, I'm going to have the vacuum on straight away, as there was a lot of dust, well, there still is a lot of dust all over my sort of paints and paint lids and all the rest of it. So as I say, I really did go nuts on this, and yeah, pretty much every part, every bit, had a little bit of damage to it, which I think was pretty cool. So yeah, my good old grout. I love this stuff, and this is obviously filling in any nooks, crannies, yeah, bits and pieces here and there. But also, this works really well for rust. So as you can see, I've kind of put it on bits of everywhere, even like areas that didn't have gaps. Just sort of put a little bit here and there because it is a nice rough texture. When you come to do the rust later on, which obviously you'll see later on. Yeah, it really makes the rust effect look rustier because it has got a rough texture to it, which is pretty cool. As you can see, I've primed everything in black, and I use the good old Colour Forge matte black paints. Yeah, link down below guys to the paints that I use. And yeah, like I did last time, I'm going to airbrush this just because it makes it so much quicker. And yeah, even with my sort of poor sort of skills in airbrushing, yeah, it still comes out perfect. And obviously the reason for this is, well, this is going to be turned into the biggest rust bucket going. So yeah, as long as there's some sort of paint on there prior to me doing the old rust things, then yeah, all's good. So I am trying to add a little bit of colour here and there. Obviously not too much, because hey, I do like the sort of the grimdark style, everything looking a bit sort of, yeah, dark, weathered, and just, well, just creepy looking, I guess. But yeah, with the old the pipes, I'm doing a few of them, well, a few of them are silver, a few of them are red, Yeah, just sort of vary up sort of a bit of colour here and there. So this is going to have a lot of rust over the top, but that's fine. And yeah, even the barrels, again, giving them a bit of a different colour. Again, yeah, I love using this airbrush. I say, I don't use it as much as I probably should to try and get better with it. But whenever I do use it, I do have fun. And I say, I think I'm probably always going to use this really primarily just to do terrain. As much as I would love to be able to use this to do miniatures, yeah, I think I would need to sort of, a bit of a steep learning curve there, and I would need to sort of spend a lot of time practicing. And yeah, when it comes to painting miniatures, I do like the good old slapchop method, just because it is, it's quick, fast, easy, I enjoy it, and I always know the results are always going to be great. Well, great for me, that is. Obviously, a lot of people might not like that sort of method. They prefer to do, well, building up with layers and all the rest, which is great. But yeah, as we're all different, we all have different sort of ideas of how we want to do things. Yeah, slapchop painting technique for me is the miniature way. But yeah, the terrain, definitely terrain, the airbrush is just so much fun. So that's the majority of the main painting done. As I say, in my head, I'm going to have obviously some toxic waste leaking out, and I really kind of wanted some lights underneath just to sort of light it up. Unfortunately, the only colour I had was blue, even though the toxic waste, I kind of want to be green. but yeah, maybe I need to get some more lights. So I only had the blue available, and I thought, well, rather than using no lights, I want to use some lights. So yeah, I'm going to use these. Obviously, the cheap, simple little LED ones don't cost much at all. Normally, you get a pack of about 12 of them for, well, about 15 quid, which isn't too bad. So yeah, I've got the wire running to the back there, so you can't really see that on the ground. Especially when I come to do the rust effect, you certainly won't get to see any of that at all. So as you can see, I'm not really doing a whole lot of a resin fill here. And in fact, I use the old UV resin out of a little bottle, a little squeezy bottle, rather than mixing up two sort of compounds together. As I say, there really isn't much needed here at all. So yeah, just painting in the base there, sort of like a nice green, well, snot kind of colour. And then obviously the kind of resin that I'm going to be using, well, I'm going to be doing that as the last sort of thing on this really. I want to get everything else done prior to that. And yeah, something I do like using now, I guess I've never really used much before, well, about the last sort of 6 months or so I started using these, I guess, and that's the old transfers. And yeah, I think these do help, well, make things look a whole lot better. Especially things like these, the little checkered flag sort of look. Yeah, this is something obviously I do have problems trying to paint. So, well, as you can see, I kind of have problems putting this on as well. But yeah, transfers, I think they're the wonderful things to use. And it's certainly something I want to start using more of, and I need to get a better collection of them, as I don't really have sort of many. Certainly not for terrain pieces anyway. So guys, yeah, if you have any links on where you get sort of transfers for, or from even, that aren't sort of related to people, they're more, say, terrain bits with like numbers on, warning symbols, and all that kind of thing. Yeah, by all means, let me know. So I've only got a few transfer sheets that I've got with some of the miniatures. Although I must admit, yeah, I think a long time ago, there were some people actually sent me in some transfers. Yeah, so guys, if you've got any transfers you don't need, yeah, by all means, send them my way. Again, especially if they are sort of terrain sort of pieces, as I'll definitely put them to good use. So yeah, so things are coming along nicely. Obviously, as you can tell, it does still look far too nice, far too clean. But yeah, we are going to change that now with a good old dirty down rust. And if you've never seen or used this stuff, guys, oh, you are in for a treat. This stuff is just, it's magic in a bottle. It really is. Yeah, all you got to do is give us a good old shake and a stir. It does get very clumpy and thick down the bottom. So that's the one thing with this stuff is, obviously, most paints, you've got to shake them. This one, you really do have to shake. I say, give it a stir, mix up all that globby stuff at the bottom. But yeah, shake it for, well, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and then keep the bottle in your pocket or your hand. Keep it nice and warm, as it works better that way as well. So this stuff is great. You literally just paint it on, leave it, and it just turns into rust. It's just fantastic. So this is sent to me by those lovely guys at Dirty Down Rust. And I did mention I'm going to be doing quite a few of these big terrain sort of pieces, and asked if they could send me another bottle. To which I said, yeah, sure. And then they sent me this. Yeah, I'm in love. Look at the size of this bad boy. So yeah, this is definitely going to be enough rust to do, well, it's going to keep me going for a while. That's all I'm going to say. So yeah, cheers guys at Dirty Down Rust. Link down below, guys. Go check them out. As honestly, this stuff is magic in a bottle. It really is a case of you just, well, put it on. But what I like to do is dab it in certain areas, just to sort of get it out and about there, but then get some water on my brush and then use that to sort of move it around. Couple of reasons for this. One, obviously it'll make your dirty down rust last longer. But again, the main reason really, it's not that I'm tight, I'm just frugal with money. The main reason is it spreads it out, and then you get sort of like uneven areas, as in some areas it's more concentrated than others. So when it does do its magic and it dries, and that's when obviously it makes the rust effect, which again, it's just amazing how it works. Yeah, you'll end up with some areas rustier than others. And the other good thing is on these containers, by putting this on loads, like with the water, it then drips. So then you get some nice, lovely sort of, well, drip lines in the rust. Again, which just makes it look so much more, well, natural, if that can be done. But yeah, so initially you put it on nice and thick in sort of areas, then get your brush nice and wet, and then mix it in and let it pool, let it drip, let it do what it wants, really. Again, this is what I love about this process. You don't have to be neat. Yeah, the less neat, the better. Really just go nuts. I mean, almost do this with your eyes shut, if you really wanted to. I wouldn't advise it, because then you probably make a mess of the whole desk and everything else. But yeah, so this stuff, it does dry really quick. And as you can see, just to the left of the shot now, that stuff started drying. And yeah, it's rust. It's rust in a bottle. Again, guys, I can't get over how good this stuff is. Especially for noobs like me. This stuff, it does everything itself. You really don't have to do anything else other than slop it on and let it dry. And then this is the result. So this is where it works really well, again, over using the grout. So not only does it look like rust, because of the texture of the grout underneath, it makes it feel like grout, rust, because it's rough. And now onto a little bit of dry brushing. A little bit of dry brushing with silver. Again, this will just catch some areas and just obviously help make the whole thing sort of tie in together and look like it was originally metal, with obviously rust coming through or bits of paint coming through. And yeah, again, another little sort of thing to do, but it just makes it look so real. And it does make this look like it's a metal sort of rust bucket, which is awesome. Again, I love things that are simple and easy to do. Dry brushing is something that, yeah, I'd love doing dry brushing. But definitely with metal, it does make things look, like they were originally metal underneath, whatever's sort of coming through on the top. So that's it all painted now, and now ready for, say, the resin. So I do have the old, like, two-part resin, but for the size of the area that I'm filling in, I didn't really think it was worth it, so I'm just using this UV resin. I've got my little purple light, and yeah, I've got a couple of paints here, so the plan is to squeeze this stuff out. I mean, this one I've actually had, I've had this for about 2 years. Hardly ever really used it. I think, in fact, I probably use this more as a kind of a glue. Just because sometimes there's things I need to hold and get them sort of stuck together. So using this UV light, it's done, obviously, instantly. I know, obviously, super glues should do that. But sometimes the super glue I use, well, it's more of a 10-20 second super glue. So, yeah, my plan here is to obviously put a few different colours in here. A few little drops of paints. So the ones I'm using, I think these are the old Warhammer army paint air ones, just because obviously they're thinned down and they're quite vibrant in colour, which I really like the look of. And then using the really expensive tool here, I'm just sort of mixing it in. So obviously the resin is still wet. I've not used the UV thingy on it. I can mix and move things around really well. So the paints are sort of mixing in to the resin, I must admit, I really loved how the result came out, because, well, it came out a lot different to what I thought, because I thought it'd be nice and smooth and flat, but for some reason, I don't know if it's where the paint was and then evaporated, but it's been left with lots of little sort of potholes and divots and, yeah, weird and wonderful things. So yeah, had lots of fun doing this, and in some cases, as you can see, the paint sort of mixes in well, and in other cases, it's almost like oil on water. It doesn't quite mix, which, again, I wasn't expecting that. I thought it was mixing fully. I kind of like the fact that it doesn't all mix in. And it does have this weird and wonderful look, which is just awesome. So, yeah, using a good old UV light, if I can get it to turn on. There we go. And this makes this stuff dry in, seconds. Normally seconds. Obviously, this is it isn't thick, but it's about 2 mil, maybe 3 mil in some areas. So yeah, I had to go over it a little bit more than I probably would have done. But again, it's so much quicker and easier using the two-part resin, because most of the two-part resins, or certainly the one that I've got, is a 24-hour cure time. So it's much nicer and quicker to use this stuff. So yeah, print minis. It's like every month they have a nice big collection come out, which they kind of release over 4 weeks or four separate sort of release dates in that month, which is great because it makes it easy for you to then obviously download the bits as they released and then print them out. And as you can see, as well as obviously lovely terrain they do all these miniatures, and this is this month's. So yeah, I've got to print a few of these out to, well, inhabit my board. So you might have seen the little cinematic video that I did with this, and I kind of want to make a little story up, which is why I've got obviously this evil winged sort of, well, I don't want to say the word, but you know what kind of thing this looks like. Yes, that's why I've gone with this as being obviously the mean machine in this little thing. And yeah, I printed out a few of the other people just to make, well, a nice little storyline to go with it. So I've kept things nice and simple with the paint job on these, primarily because I wanted him to sort of look kind of dark. So I didn't really like the idea of making him sort of like bright colours and purples and whites, as I do obviously love the old, Alien. So yes, having him all black was kind of my first thought, but as you'll see, I kind of went with all black, but then I thought, yeah, he's a bit too black, and then I did a bit of dry brushing with some purple, just as this will help show off obviously all the lovely detail. Yes, again, guys, all the other miniatures that print minis do, full of detail, variety, and just look awesome. And again, these are all pre-supported as well, so there was no issues at all printing these out. And yeah, they all came out first time and perfectly, which is just great. So that's the beast done in my little storyline. And yeah, it's a very simple, very quick, but I do like how he looks. And obviously, if you've seen the little cinematic video, you'll have seen these poor guys. Yeah, these didn't do too well against it. But again, I love the fact there's so many sort of variety of miniatures and wounded ones. Well, and there's a few dead ones here as well. But yeah, I do like these guys that are sort of like pulling their mates away to try and get them out of, harm's way. And obviously we now need the heroes to come in. And again, these are modular, which I just love. So these guys can be sort of printed out, set up however you want. Different arm variations, different gun variations, and different heads. So I've kind of gone for the three sort of different heads, as in there's one wearing a hat or mask or helmet. I'll get there in the end. One that's wearing nothing, and one that's just got like a face. A bit of breathing apparatus. But yeah, again, there we go. Supports come off perfectly. So these, I'm not even bothering now putting things in a wash. Not a wash, in warm water. But again, this is also because I'm using this sunlu resin, which is just awesome. And you will see me using that quite a bit. As, yeah, I love the results of it. And again, things just come apart so well. And it does have a bit more of a rubber feel to it. So if I was to drop this, it certainly wouldn't break. But yeah, I love how the fact these have some great poses and obviously a variety of weapons. These ones pretty much are, I think they're like flamethrowers. But yeah, I love how these look and the fact that you can just interchange them, which is just great. Obviously, as these are resin ones, yeah, you do need to use normal sort of glue with this. Yeah, you wouldn't be able to use the like cement glue because obviously that just wouldn't work. So I've only printed out three of these bad boys. I think there was about eight in the sort of this month's collection at Print Minis. And yeah, again, I love the fact that obviously different sort of heads, which is really cool. And yeah, love how these look. These really are beefy, chunky, space heroes. So yeah, these are going to get a good old slapchop painted as well. And again, I'm keeping these nice and simple. And I'm primarily painting these in good old magic blue. This does seem to be a nice colour for the old these space dudes. And yeah, as you can see, already sort of primed, dry brushed. And I am now just dry brushing with white. Obviously, in the past, I've always done the old dry brush and grey, dry brush white. And a lot of you guys have said, why do I do the grey bit? And to be honest, I don't know. I think it's because the first time I ever looked and saw someone doing it, they did the grey and then the white, so I kind of followed suit. But yeah, definitely for miniatures, especially when they've got lots of detail like these ones, you don't really need the grey because it pretty much gets covered in the dry brush, the white. So yeah, I now just dry brush in white, which is obviously a bit more of a time saver as well, which is pretty cool. So yeah, I really, really enjoyed the full build process of this and obviously painting the miniatures. And I've just seen what the time is, guys. So if you are still with me, yeah, certainly hats off to you, as I think this is now officially my longest video. Even though this has been cut down from, well, quite a lot more footage. Yeah, I just wanted to show with you the whole process of this and pretty much how good print minis miniatures are. And like I say, the full variety of terrain pieces, which I'm certainly going to be using lots of, as well as obviously the lovely miniatures they do as well. So yeah, don't forget guys, check out all the links sort of down below. Okay, well that's enough waffle for now. If you haven't already seen it, I am now going to show the little cinematic little clip, and then we'll have a little talk about the whole thing afterwards. So yeah, enjoy these guys in all their glory. And there we go guys, so there's my second sort of modular terrain tile piece, which I love, and I say, I love these little miniatures, they look awesome in it as well. So yeah, so I can't wait now to start on, well, the third one of these. As I say, it's initially I want to make six, just because it will be the right sort of size to play kill team. So guys, don't forget, leave some comments down below, let me know what sort of tiles you want me to make, as in like themes of each tile. And if I can, yeah, I'll certainly have a go at, well, giving it a go. I just want to say another big thank you to Print Minis for obviously sponsoring this video, as well as letting me have access to, well, all their lovely files. As yeah, I just love them. I say they do such a large variety, which is great, especially for this sort of style and theme look. Yeah, they've got you covered in everything you can think of, which is great. As I say, I will be doing, say, four more boards, and they're all going to look different, and they're all going to primarily use most of Print Mini's bits and pieces. I also want to say a big shout out and thank you to all my lovely patrons, as well as Chaos Cards and the Color Forge, for helping support the channel every month, which is great, guys. Thank you so much. Again, links down below to, yeah, to all that good stuff. And if you want to become a patron and sort of see what I'm currently working on before it comes on YouTube, then, yeah, consider sort of supporting me over there. Okay, guys, there's another video on the screen. Go give that a click. Like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.